Happy Valentine's Day from public sector workers from across the country.
I did it again.
You're not on script at all.
Is there going to be a blooper reel?
Yeah, my name is Don Moran. I'm a senior officer with the Canadian Union of Public Employees. And we've come out, obviously, in support of three events here, right, that are going on. One being the Cindy Blackstock's case, the AFN, with regards to discrimination against children. And I really like the event that happened here, the rally, the children, the Have a Heart. I think it's really appropriate being Valentine's Day in that. But at the same time, raising a good awareness with regards to what's going on across this country with regards to the children, the Aboriginal children in the communities that they are in. I like some of the signs, the Stephen Harper's 600 miles, send your child to school 600 kilometers away. They're great signs, a great education, a great awareness. I hope it gets some media attention. When you look at the statistics across this country once again, when we're looking at the Aboriginal socioeconomic conditions, it's terrible. And we need to do something about it. Us in the union, we're doing our bit. And I say a bit because it's not everything. We got lots to do, a lot of work. This is only steps into the progression, let's say, of getting rid of all this discriminatory practices and systemic discrimination.
Well, the first thing I want to do is say a big thank you and happy Valentine's Day to Cindy Blackstock for all the work that she does on behalf of First Nations children across this country. Her devotion and her dedication is unmatched, and if there was 10 more like her, we'd have this problem solved tomorrow. My name is Michael Desautels. I'm an Aboriginal rights officer with the Public Service Alliance of Canada. We represent most workers in the federal public service. And we're here today because we think that the situation facing Aboriginal children is unconscionable. When their schools receive $2,000 to $3,000 less per student per year than provincially funded schools, it's starting kids off at a disadvantage. And a time when there's so many other pressures and demands on First Nations children to do well, they're unable to because they just don't have the resources to it. And there's a whole barrage of issues facing First Nations communities. And so if their children are at a disadvantage, then we have a responsibility for people who don't live in First Nations to do something about it. So that's why we're here. That's why our union and Don's union and several other affiliates of the Canadian Labour Congress are working to raise public awareness about this issue with our members and with the general public.
Hi there, my name's Brian Edgecombe. I work for the Canadian Union of Public Employees as well. And my partner is a teacher at Lady Evelyn. I was out today. It's very simple. I'm supporting the kids. This was mostly about kids from schools coming out and talking with kids from other schools about why people don't get the same kind of education coast to coast, whether they're on reserve or off reserve. And what's really distressing, and the kids will tell you this more than anyone else, is they seem to get something that this federal government doesn't get, that you can't treat kids differently. And the message is simple, treat us all the same. So it's a really simple thing to do, to come out and support 300 kids that are coming out and trying to say to the Prime Minister, if you can't get it right, go back to grade 5.